Welcome the SKTC members to our Griffin Racing team. I am Adam Frederick from the team of Griffin Racing. Darkas, Adikaran and Vijay here to present our design report. I call upon Vijay to present.
I am going to talk about our specifications. We have two standard engine control devices. First one, the overall height is 38 inch. Overall length is 71 inch. Overall width is 38 inch. The mass of the vehicle of our cart is 91 kgs. The tank capacity of our cart is 4 liters. Ground clearance of our cart is 1.7 inch. Ground clearance means in between distance between down to the chain sprocket. The wheelbase of our cart is 47 inch.
Here comes the chassis view of our go-kart. The first is isometric view and the second one is top view. The material selection of our go-kart is done by this method. The methodology is we have studied the rule book and selected the material. The free expression is done and the design analysis is done by the SolidWorks and ANSYS software. The final report has been submitted. These are the material properties and the material we have used is ASTM A106 grade B. Distance of CG from layer B is 0.46 meter. Height of CG is 0.52 meter. Carbon content of the material is 0.3%. Ultimate strength, shear modulus and Poisson ratio are 413.4, 92.31, 0.3 respectively. The final element analysis is the first two are front impact and the second two are rear impact. These two are right impact and the two are left impact. Each are divided into two categories, total deformation and the maximum combined stress. The analysis of the reports are mentioned at the bottom of the slide.
So next is about safety and ergonomics and innovations. So let's start with the methodology. The first thing is rule book study. Second one is analyzing the required safety features of the cart. Next it's surveying safety equipment. Next it's cleansing the finest quality equipment. So that whenever we build something, the finest quality is required. So next step is assembly process. And the last step is final inspection. Now ergonomics provided for driver comfort. Lavishly line of vision. So whenever a driver drives a car, he needs a lot of vision so that he has a vision of road and the oncoming vehicles. Next it is copious comfort. Whenever a driver drives a car, he needs a lot of comfort so that he does not go in end in fatigue. Next it is easy reach to every component. So whenever a driver drives a car, there is a requirement of easy approach to the equipment. So if not, there might be some distractions. So we have kept the design like where the driver can approach the equipment easily. Next it is firewall provided to protect driver from the engine heat. So there is an enormous amount of heat produced from the engine. So when this much amount of heat is produced, the driver might get distracted. So there is a firewall provided between the engine and the driver so that the driver does not get distracted. Next it is floor pan is provided under the chassis. So the floor pan is provided. So the unwanted material or foreign materials under the chassis does not enter the cabin of the cart. Next it is innovations. Bumper impact system. So bumper impact system means whenever a go-kart goes under a crash or accident, a sensor which kills the engine supply, engine power, so that the engine gets off. Next one it is disc brake cooling bucket. So whenever a driver drives a cart, the continuous use of disc brake heats up the disc. So the disc brake gets a lot of heat. So there is a pathway cooling system so that disc brake gets cool often. Next it is side mounted engine. Side mounted, the advantages of having it is the load from the engine is distributed evenly all over the frame. Next it is about the adjustable steering so that driver of all heights are capable of sitting in the cart. Next it is the muffler. So the muffler is required so that the emissions from the engine is reduced and noise from the engine is reduced.
Here comes the powertrain of our go-kart. Under the references of the rule book, the engine displacement is restricted to 125cc. So we have planned to have a Countach Sunner engine which can deliver an engine displacement of 124.7cc. So the engine can able to deliver a power of maximum
11 bhp at 8000 rpm and the maximum torque of 11 nm at 6500 rpm. So the engine is fitted with a single cylinder and there are two valves and the transmission is a 5-gear transmission and we have a belt multi-link clutch. So here is the powertrain layout. We have planned to have a rear engine rear wheel drive so the power can be easily delivered to the wheels very efficiently and the power can be transmitted through the means of chain sprocket. Then here are the several calculations made by our team. So the so next is about the braking system. So let's start with the methodology. First thing is literature study on braking system, and next one is selection of a perfect braking system so that we can select the perfect design and calculations. Material and caliper selection. Here we have selected EN8 and calipers of Marcy 800s. And next one is calibration of the braking system, and next one is thermal analysis of the disc so that the heat is emitted from the disc due to friction. And the last one is final design report. So here are few specifications of the disc brake, and the thickness of the disc is 4.5 mm, and outer diameter of the disc is 150 mm, inner diameter is 35 mm, and few specifications are mentioned here, and these are few calculated values of the braking system. Here comes the failure modes of effort analysis. First is the power drain. The chain socket will be disengaged, so the power will not be efficiently transmitted to the wheels. So the chain should be tightened, so for the efficiency of the power. Next is chassis. The chassis will be cracked due to the heavy impact load on it. So some of the lab analysis should be done to avoid this kind of problems. Next is brakes. Overheating of brakes. This test is done so in the thermal analysis, so the brake can be working in efficient manner. Here it is a DVP plan, so it is a design validation plan. Here are several tests are connected by our go-kart numbers. Some of the tests are NDT test, which is called as non-visible test. Next is design software test, it overcomes by being some of the many analysis softwares. Next is multi-grid testing. It is undergoes the battery test, which is useful for our battery life. Next is muffler test, which is used to avoid the carbon emission. Then next is a kill switch test. It is used to stop the engine in any dangerous situations. It is a project plans of our go-kart team. Here are some of the activities given there. So we have planned to finish our go-kart within a given time. So this is our plan.
The cost distribution and weight distribution report is in this slide. The frame and body is designed around 30,000, the engine transmission is around 20,000, the brakes is designed for 7,000, and the wheels and tires is around 16,000, the steering is designed around 3,000, the electricals is designed around 3,000, the tooling cost is around 12,000, the miscellaneous intent finish is around 5,500, and the total cost of the vehicle is around 80,208. The weight has been calculated, is split up into several divisions: frame and body, engine and transmission, brakes, wheels, steering, electrical, safety equipment, and miscellaneous. The total weight of the vehicle is around 91 kg. And finally, the pie chart of the weight cost report is shown at the bottom of the slide.
So, manufacturing facilities. The fabrication process, cutting, drilling, grinding, milling, and some of the process which were provided by our college, and these are few outside facilities we utilize in making our car. Thank you for giving us this wonderful opportunity.